We're here with this. Look, see, I'll get you, man, exclusives behind the scenes stuff. Yeah, we're here with the future of the welterweight division,
of course.
Chris Two Slick Kongo doing his groceries. Yeah, as you can see, this is a box of groceries. What we got here?
We got a courgette.
We got a courgette.
Baby tomatoes.
Baby tomatoes.
Got the salmon.
Salmon.
Asparagus.
Asparagus. Apples. Got some
Granny Smith apples.
Apples.
We ain't finished yet though.
It's looking tasty out here, man. It's looking tasty.
Yeah. It's gonna be tasty. Something nice, something healthy.
Yeah.
What athletes should be eating, you know?
Yeah.
Over here, well, I don't know about any others, but I take my profession serious.
Right.
You gotta eat right, sleep right, train right.
Yeah.
Everything, man.
Yeah.
It's all part of the package.
And obviously, we're going all the way to the top, so we've got to keep this going from now.
100%. 100%. That's how it goes.
Big, big, big. So, obviously, me and you were at the copper box on the weekend for the...
What's the box?
The Tank and Liam Walsh fight.
Yeah.
How did you feel about that card, man?
The card was good. I liked the card. I liked Anthony Yard. He done his thing.
Uh-huh.
He showed there's levels in this game. It didn't look like my man wanted to be in there with him.
Yeah.
So he wasn't, and two, he wasn't able to handle the power.
Right.
He was too sharp. Too sharp, too strong. Cross was strong.
Too sharp, too strong.
Yeah. Let's go this way.
On a bit of a different plateau, really.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. So. Apart from that, obviously the main interest was Liam Walsh and Javonte Davis.
Before we get to that one, talk to me about Daniel Dubois. What do you think of this guy?
I've literally forgot about him. Daniel Dubois, the next up-and-coming heavyweight coming out of the UK. There ain't going to be no other heavyweight like him.
19 years old.
He's 19, he's strong. I used to train with Daniel Dubois when he was a young kid, when he was 14. But now, he's a man. He's matured. He's still a kid, but he's matured into a man.
Yeah.
So...
He's developed now.
He's developed. And he's taking people out. I've seen him take 2 to 3 people out in sparring. Just in sparring.
In the same sparring session?
In a sparring session. And just remember... He's wearing 18-ounce gloves. So imagine with 10-ounce gloves. These guys are falling straight.
Yeah.
You understand?
Yeah.
So it's one of them ones where I think he will get somewhere, 100%.
So we're saying the future champ.
He's the future champ. I was currently on Team GB myself, so I've seen him give people good work. I've seen him give the likes of Fraser Clark, Joe Joyce, good work. Unfortunately, I wasn't there to see him spar against Anthony Joshua. I heard rumors, but only them two know what really happened.
Uh-huh.
You know what I mean? So, time will tell. I mean, he's got a lot of time on his hands.
Yeah.
Definitely a lot more time than me anyway.
Yeah.
But he's doing his thing. He's doing his thing. You got to rate him. You got to rate him.
You got to.
100%.
So, yeah, the main event, man.
Going on to the main event, I mean, Javonte Davis was just another level.
Once again, it's the levels thing.
Once again, it's the levels thing. You know? Sugar Snap Peas. Excuse me. You don't know where Sugar Snap Peas is.